Greetings, comrades. Graduation is quickly approaching, and we have a special announcement. The Queen is delivering a special message. Pay attention. Failure to conform will result in immediate repercussion. Am I clear, comrades?
Yes, comrade.
We are so fortunate to live in this great and wonderful society, where every member works together to achieve great things for the greater good. In the new world, being the same unites us and makes us stronger as a whole. Our state has truly made life simple and has maximized efficiency by making everything the same for all. The home is organized, simple, and structured. Every home must be the same in order to promote our similarities. We all have the same electric stove to promote jobs in the manufacturing industry. We all drive the same Edison 557 state-sponsored car. Our power is provided by New World Electric. We all get our food conveniently at State Mart, and we all wear the same issue of shell gray clothes. Finally, we are each expected to go to school until the age of 15, and after graduation is complete, each member of society is assigned a different job. As you will soon be graduating, you will be entering a new phase of life called the working phase. I am very happy to announce that each of you have been chosen to be society's next group of home builders. You will be responsible for building the homes that everyone lives in, as well as all the other important buildings the state requires. Each home must be identical to the next and comes with detailed instructions to ensure our communal success. Having the same homes allows them to be equally dependable. And if a building is made of something other than state-issued bricks, it disrupts our community of equality. Our world thrives off of similarity as it brings us great power and protects us. I cannot stress how important these next few years will be in perfecting your skills. Thank you, comrades, for listening so attentively. Remember now, here in the new world, everything has a purpose. Queen Philopolis signing off.
Comrades, do you understand the premise of this important presentation?
Yes, comrade teacher.
Let's start with today's lesson then. Now, which one of you can tell me what a deviant is? Comrade Sam, answer.
That's a bad word, comrade teacher.
It is permitted for the purpose of education. Comrade Pagan, I see you have your hand raised.
Deviants are the evil in society.
Excellent, comrade. Deviants infect us with difference. They destroy our unity and threaten society. The old world collapsed because of their sacrilegious and devilish thoughts.
Rule 5, subsection C. Contact with deviants is strictly prohibited. Communicating with deviants will result in life imprisonment.
Thank you, comrade. Yes, comrade?
How do you spot a deviant?
There are many telltale signs to spot a deviant. They talk informally. They hide away from the rest of us and want to be different. They also have this vile mark on their arm, so we can easily identify them.
But why do they have the mark?
Comrade Alex, are you a fool? You do not speak unless spoken to. Am I clear?
Yes, comrade teacher.
To answer your question, comrade, after the great patriotic revolution, the glorious victors mark all the survivors who weren't willing to accept our superior way of thinking, so they can always be seen as those who weren't willing to conform. Your homework is to read pages 57 to 103 of your societal functions and textbook.
We are one and one the same.
Dismissed. Comrade Alex, as a punishment for your vile call-out, you have been tasked to clean all the desks.
Yes, comrade teacher. Oh, you comrades go ahead. I'll catch up to you.
Okay, see you tomorrow for your day.
Comrade, this isn't the first time that this has happened. I sure hope you learn your lesson, because next time will result in serious reprimand.
Why not, you deviant scum?
Because I'm not a deviant scum.
I'm a human being, and I'm part of a movement that's trying to change society back to the way things used to be. The way things should be! Don't report me until you've had a chance to hear what I have to say. You can make your own opinion, something you don't get to do very often. Listen, every day the state rounds up people like me and captures us. Life wasn't always like this. Before your people took over, we were free to say and do whatever we wanted. Everything being controlled is so problematic. Everyone having the same house, the same stove, the same opinions is so dull and lifeless. Had you lived back then, you'd be a deviant now too, and if you didn't know any better, maybe you would think that's okay.
So wait, you used to be able to state your own opinions freely, even if it was against the queen?
There wasn't a queen to follow back then. People used to do things not because they had to, but because they wanted to.
How is that possible? How could a society like that even exist?
Yeah, it worked even better than this one. People weren't afraid to be themselves. We had so many colors other than gray, like red and blue. Everything was different. Everyone behaved differently.
Red? Who is that? Is she cute?
No. This is Red.
Oh, my great queen, this is beautiful!
Yeah, I know, my hair is pretty great.
I was talking about the color.
Oh, yeah, that too.
But how do you make them?
With this.
What is that thing?
It's an artifact from the old ancient world. It's called a paintbrush, and it has the power to change the world as we see it.
But how could this change society when this one works just fine?
Do you like living in this world where the only emotion is fear? Do you like this world where you only care about yourself and every day you're stuck in the same old routine?
But routines are good. They offer us structure and support, and it's not my place to care about others.
You're blinded by your own ignorance. Look.
Oh my God!
There are so many colors you've never been allowed to see. Do you feel anything?
Yeah, I do. I don't know what it is though. I don't know how to describe it. There's just so many things I want to say right now, but...
Yes, that's the feeling of the past, the feeling of freedom.
But why did everything change?
With this great freedom of expression comes the responsibility to use it properly. People used to disagree about politics and social movements all the time. Instead of respecting one another's opinions, people just kept getting more and more offended. Eventually, people started threatening each other, using their words to just be so mean and downright cruel. People forgot how to disagree respectfully. If I were to paint the queen and falling off a horse, and then getting trampled over by a show pony...
Wait, okay, no, that's terrible.
Hold your horses. That's exactly what I'm talking about. I think that's hilarious, but... You don't, man. That's okay. That's why the old world was so glorious. We understood that there were differences of opinion, and we all lived together in harmony for a while. People started becoming more sensitive. Eventually, we were barely able to make a joke without offending someone. When the government proposed to remove all outlets of self-expression, the public welcomed it with open arms because of the supposed comfort it provided. As time went on, the government possessed greater and greater power, and with no one to challenge it, all individual rights and freedoms were completely stripped away. And here we are today.
But that's wrong.
Yes, why?
I don't know.
You will understand eventually. Hush, I hear someone. I have to go.
Are you gonna be okay?
Don't worry about me, friend. I'll be okay. Thanks, though. Now, go!
Please start by opening desk compartment alpha and begin the procedure.
Good job, Comrade Sam and Comrade Payton. Your houses match your tutorial exactly.
Thank you, Comrade Teacher.
Alex, you're slacking. Pick up the pace.
No problem, fam.
Pardon me, Comrade?
I mean, yes, Comrade Teacher. Guys, look what I did.
Comrade Alex, what have you done?
It's pretty groovy, isn't it? It's the color red.
That's a color?
Yeah, isn't it great?
Comrade Alex, you're not making sense anymore. What are these words you're using? Groovy? That is an acceptable language I published by Queen.
Chill out, man. I don't know why you're making such a big stink out of this.
Comrade Alex, you're broken the first rule, the rule of the words. You know it's not trying to speak as a language I. And furthermore, you are acting really strange.
Please, babe. I thought you were my friend.
Get a hold of yourself. There are no friends, only comrades. I know what you truly are now. A disgusting, filthy, vile deviant. When I report to PCO, I'll be praised as hero. I'll be promoted to be house tutor, and all I'll do is report you.
I thought everything you did was supposed to be for the betterment of the party, not yourself.
Reporting deviants always betters the party. The promotion just bonus. Say goodbye, comrades. Officer, officer.
What is it, comrade?
Comrades, the deviant. Look at what's done.
The state appreciates your service, comrade. I'll report this to the Queen immediately. Your Majesty.
Yes, comrade?
I have good news and bad news, Your Majesty.
Well, then what is it?
Well, we found another deviant.
What? I thought we executed them all during the 5-year purge, damn it! Do I not have competent officers? I must have them executed!
Your Majesty, please do not worry. It's just one simple deviant. He stands no chance against the state. He must have just simply slipped through the cracks. But please do not be concerned. I have this problem completely under control, and I expect it to be solved in the next few days.
Excellent. You are dismissed.
At first, I didn't fully understand the significance of what Oswald said. I mean, she sounded kind of nuts, but when I saw all those beautiful colors, I felt something change inside of me. For once, I didn't feel gray. I didn't even know gray was even a feeling until I felt something different. To challenge the rules, all these years I thought that was bad. I had to be a product of the new world. But now, I know there's more to life. I want to be able to form my own opinions, have my own experiences, express myself, take chances, make mistakes, and live a life worth living. I want to be creative, put myself out there, and not be afraid to grow into who I'm meant to be by my own rules. I mean, sometimes people will like you, and other times they won't. That's life, and that's okay. You can't get along and agree with everyone, but you can show respect for the differences in opinion. Who knows? Maybe some people are just afraid of new ideas. At the end of the day, we're all human. But when we fall down, we get right back up. But only if we're given the choice to.
Alex! Ah! What do you think you're doing?
I don't know, I just lost my mind. I just need something to express myself on.
So you chose to express yourself on this?
Okay, how else am I supposed to show my colorful ideas in this gray world?
That's easy. You don't. The society has no room for people like you to have your own ideas. All the good ones have already been made.
Okay, come on. Don't you feel anything when you look at this painting?
Look, kid. This painting you did, I like it a lot. A lot more than I should admit as a servant of the state. It's got me thinking, that's for sure, but it won't change anything. Alex, you must conform to the way of the world. It's the only way to survive.
No.
The society we live in isn't ready for change. It's not ready for new ideas. Between you and me, I think you're onto something, but I can't let it happen. I have a job, and there are rules that we all must follow. You're a good kid, so I'll give you a choice. You can either come with me, I'll take you to a rehabilitation center. You give up your paintbrush, promise to never express yourself again, and the world goes back to how it was. Of course, you'll have to do some community service, but nothing too severe. Or you run. And you don't stop running. I won't say a word about this. This will stay between you and me. But just know, the New World Police are onto you. I'm just the first of many. And I can't promise the others will be as merciful.
So come with me. Please give me the opportunity to do so on his behalf.
Officer, your request is highly unusual, but I'll allow it. Proceed.
Alex is not a bad kid. He just wants to live his life to the fullest, and the only thing stopping him is us. The state. We are the ones stopping him from expressing his views freely and making his own decisions. I thought the same as you, but then I caught Alex painting. And then I started to paint, and I felt the raw emotion and power that only art can create. To fully find yourself through the arts means much more than any words on a sheet of paper. To me, artistic expression is what being human really means. Society needs to change. Not for all, but for those who need the arts and color and difference in their lives.
Officer, you do realize you're admitting to conspiring against the state, and at that, you'll likely be tried the same way Alex is right now?
Yes. And I have something else to admit.
What is it now?
You cannot try Comrade Alex.
And why not, officer? Are you telling a state judge what to do? You are way out of line.
I have retained evidence from the courts, and Rule 27, Subsection A specifically states that a trial cannot go on if there is evidence retained from the courts.
Give me a moment to think about this, officer.
What are you doing? You're risking your job and possibly your life. You basically admitted to being a deviant.
I know, but it's the right thing to do. Earlier, when you chose a life on the run, I was shocked. You were so brave to risk everything for what you believe in, and it made me realize that I can be strong too. For once, I felt different, and I felt free, and I felt a level of happiness that I'd never reached in my entire life. I couldn't let you rot away in the cell for the rest of your life, for something that could bring so much meaning to the meaningless world we live in.
Careful consideration, I must rule this mistrial. Comrade Alex will await his retrial. The exact date is yet to be set. As the defendant does not pose an imminent threat to society, I will grant him bail. He will be monitored by the Queen Philopolis police and will be required to check in with them frequently. As for the officer, an investigation will be launched with potential legal repercussions, but that is not in my jurisdiction. Court adjourned. Gentlemen, I would like to show you something, but before I do, I'd like to say I'm happy I'm not the only one.
What do you mean, Comrade Judge?
Now with that being said, if you ever need a warm meal or a roof under your head, you know where to find me.
Is she?
Yeah, a deviant.
What do you think's gonna happen to us?
Who knows? Worst case, we get caught, but this color thing, I think it could change the world.
Well then, grab a paintbrush. We got work to do.
Let's go!